माननीय मुख्यमंत्री जी से अनुरोध करूंगा और उपस्थित सभी अतिथियों से अनुरोध करूंगा कि जो गाइडलाइन है उसका विमोचन करने का कष्ट करें।
पॉलिसी है उसकी तरफ इम्प्लीमेंटेशन गाइडलाइंस का अभी भी विमोचन माननीय मुख्यमंत्री जी के कर कमलों द्वारा और इस नीति के सुचारू कार्यान्वयन को सुनिश्चित करने की तरफ ये गाइडलाइंस रिलीज की जा रही है। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद माननीय मुख्यमंत्री जी। और मध्य प्रदेश अपने मनोरम दृश्य के लिए, पर्यटन स्थानों के लिए और अतिथि देवो भव भाव के लिए जाना जाता है, तो टूरिज्म और हॉस्पिटैलिटी क्षेत्र में जो अनंत संभावनाएं हैं, जो अनुकूल नीतियां हैं, उसके बारे में विस्तृत जानकारी देते हुए अब डिटेल प्रेजेंटेशन हमारे श्री श्री शेखर शुक्ला जी की तरफ से, प्रिंसिपल सेक्रेटरी टूरिज्म।
ऑनरेबल चीफ मिनिस्टर सर, ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर्स, ऑनरेबल स्टीम गेस्ट ऑन द डेस ऑफ द डेस, welcome to the spiritual capital of Madhya Pradesh and India and also gateway to nature, Jabalpur. I will just start with a small AV. A lot of business has been talked about, so let us now relax, sit back and see this AV on tourism and culture. Please start. These are the heritage sites and six of them have been recently included just 3 months ago. Next please. When it comes to spirituality and pilgrimage, we are second to none, home to 2 Jyotirlingas and many other very pious religious places, one of them being Amarkantak, which is the origin of one of the oldest river on the planet, Narmadaji, and there are many more attractions around it. Next please. So that was a little bit about some of these offerings. We are also have got strong capabilities when it comes to MICE or leisure or wellness. I won't go into details. We'll have a thematic session 1:30 to 2:30. All of you are welcome who are interested to join us over there. We will give you more details. Of course, I will also take this opportunity to talk a little bit about business. We have got one of the best tourism policies in the country, where we are helping the investors in many ways. If you have got your own land or you have procured land and you have created any of these tourism infrastructure, then we are here to support you by way of capital subsidy and other kind of incentives. We are also offering very, very attractive and suitably located land parcels throughout the state. We have got a land bank of more than 1300 hectares, and we also have got around 20 heritage properties which are on the offer to create any kind of heritage hotel. And for these policies to implement, whether it is your own land or it is a government land which you take through our policy on the bidding, through the bidding process, you are offered all these incentives. The lease is given for 90 years and on a very attractive proposition. For those investors who are here to invest more than 100 crores in tourism and hospitality sector, we lay red carpet for them. There is no bidding, nothing. They simply have to submit their proposal, which is authentic, which is well curated, and we take it through our screening process, and they are given the incentives right away. 30% of the capex is reimbursed to the investor who comes to my state in the tourist footfall in the state. And we have crossed 10 crore mark. We registered somewhere around 11.5 crore tourists in the state during 2023, and this trend is going to continue for years to come. Next please. Next. Yeah, some of these land parcel details are there. Next please. Next. So we are also foraying into PPP when it comes to tourism. We are offering glamping sites to put up luxurious tent cities. We also have got some of these properties of Madhya Pradesh Tourism Corporation on the offer for long-term lease on PPP basis. We also promote caravan tourism, golf courses, ropeways, And there's another very active proposition which is coming about is cruise tourism. We are going to start number of cruise routes in Madhya Pradesh, inside the Madhya Pradesh and connecting intrastate. One of the cruise which we are going to start is from Statue of Oneness in Omkarishwar, Adi Shankaracharya, the statue over there, from there to Statue of Unity in Gujarat, around 120 kilometer route. We are going to start very luxurious cruise, and the offer would be given for the PPP players to come and invest over there. We have got a very attractive and one of the best film tourism policy in the country, which is attracting a lot of traction, and you name the film producer, they love coming to Madhya Pradesh and shooting. And when it comes to Jabalpur, it is really their delight to be working in Jabalpur. It's coming up as a tourism and also film shooting hub in Madhya Pradesh. Next, please. So not only we provide ease of shooting here by way of online permissions and complete hand-holding, seamless hand-holding, but we also, icing on the cake is financial incentives. We also give 25% of the cost of the project, or up to 2 crore as an incentive for film, for OTT web series, etc. We also give incentives. So now you can see, next please. Some of these big films which have been shot, both international and national projects, which have put Madhya Pradesh majorly on the film tourism map of the country. Lion, White Tiger, Suitable Boy, The Lovers, and you see the array of movies which have been shot here in Madhya Pradesh and well appreciated and widely acclaimed. Next, please. We are also home to many, many opportunities when it comes to eco and adventure tourism. I won't go into details. Next, please. So this is a snapshot, brief snapshot of what we are doing here in Madhya Pradesh. What are the opportunities for the investors to come and invest in Madhya Pradesh? I invite all of you to not only invest, but be invested in Madhya Pradesh when it comes to cultural and tourism offerings. I must also conclude by saying that my Honorable Chief Minister's commitment was shown within 3 months of his assuming office. His prime concern was intrastate connectivity, and he gave us directions, and we could start intrastate air services within the states, connecting 8 destinations. That goes a long way to show his commitment, and also the team's resolve to put Madhya Pradesh majorly on the tourism and hospitality map. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, sir. So, ladies and gentlemen, these were the brief snapshots of the investment opportunities, the policies, the incentives, and some of the potential and blooming sectors of Madhya Pradesh. और आगे बढ़ते हुए अब मंचासीन हमारे जो कुछ प्रमुख उद्योगपति हमारे साथ हैं, उनके विचारों को, उनकी प्रतिबद्धताओं को, और क्योंकि उन्होंने मध्य प्रदेश में निवेश किया हुआ है, तो उनके अनुभवों को आमंत्रित करते हैं, और जो अपेक्षाएं भी हैं उनकी मध्य प्रदेश शासन से, सरकार से, वह भी जानने की कोशिश करते हैं। तो सबसे पहले मैं आमंत्रित करती हूँ श्री जॉयदीप मुखर्जी को, CEO हिडलबर्ग सीमेंट। दुनिया भर में 50 से अधिक देशों में हिडलबर्ग क्षमता और गुणवत्ता का प्रतीक है। दमोह मध्य प्रदेश में इनका प्लांट है, और मायसम के नाम से इनका सीमेंट वर्ल्ड फेमस है।
थैंक यू Honorable Chief Minister of Madhya Pradesh, Mr. Mohan Yadav, MD of MPIDC, Mr. Chandramouli Shukla, esteemed guests, ladies and gentlemen, I stand before you today with a deep sense of gratitude and optimism as we gather to acknowledge your commitment to industrial development under your visionary leadership, your unwavering commitment to foster a conducive business environment and promoting economic growth has been instrumental, sir, in our collective success. On behalf of Heidelberg Cement India, I extend my heartfelt gratitude to you for your continuous support and engagement. Your commitment to Madhya Pradesh's development has created an environment that nurtures businesses like ours. Your policies focused on industrial development, on ease of doing business, and skill development programs have been instrumental in our ability to expand, innovate, and contribute to this state's economy. Thanks to your vision and unwavering dedication, the state is going to evolve further into a beacon of innovation and industry. We have at Heidelberg successfully concluded expansion projects in the past in Damo, and we are making significant investments now in alternative fuels, in sustainable development, power and renewable energy initiatives. Looking ahead, we are now preparing to invest an additional 1500 crores over the next 4 to 5 years in our expansion initiatives. We are proud to be part of this journey towards progress and prosperity, and we also actively contribute to CSR activities that uplift the surrounding community. Your leadership has inspired us to dream big and achieve even bigger. We look forward to continuing our partnership with your government in furthering our shared goal of sustainable economic development. We laud the idea of these regional conclaves, and we think it's an excellent idea which bestows sharp focus on regional development. And once again, I thank you for your invaluable support and for creating an environment where businesses can thrive and contribute to the growth story of our state. Thank you very much.
Tromso EV Private Limited, Nature Co Pulp Private Limited, CBA India Private Limited, Spark VR Technologies Private Limited, Family Wala eShop Private Limited, or Future Foodcraft or Nutrition Private Limited. आपको ये भी बताना चाहेंगे कि जबलपुर इंक्यूबेशन सेंटर ने पिछले साल स्मार्ट सिटी मिशन के तहत माननीय राष्ट्रपति जी द्वारा सर्वश्रेष्ठ प्रोजेक्ट पुरस्कार भी प्राप्त किया और इस क्षेत्र में अपनी श्रेष्ठता को साबित किया. तो सभी हमारे स्टार्टअप्स के लिए एक बार जोरदार तालियां हो जाए जिन्हें अभी इनका सीड फंड रिलीज किया गया है. और अब मैं आमंत्रित करती हूँ हमारे आदरणीय एमएसएमई मंत्री श्री चैतन्य कश्यप जी को कि वह सम्मानित सभागार को संबोधित करें.
रीजनल इंडस्ट्री कॉन्क्लेव महाकौशल क्षेत्र में आज हमारे मुख्यमंत्री डॉक्टर मोहन यादव जी के आतिथ्य में संपन्न होने जा रहा है. आज यहाँ उपस्थित हमारे इस क्षेत्र के वरिष्ठ नेता श्री प्रहलाद पटेल जी, पंचायत एवं ग्रामीण विकास मंत्री श्री राकेश सिंह जी, लोक निर्माण मंत्री श्री संपत्या उइके जी, लोक स्वास्थ्य यांत्रिकी विभाग श्री लखन पटेल जी, माननीय मंत्री पशुपालन एवं डेयरी विकास श्री धर्मेंद्र लोधी जी, मंत्री पर्यटन एवं संस्कृति तथा यहाँ उपस्थित अभी हमने जिनके भाव सुने, श्री विनोद अग्रवाल जी, जयदीप मुखर्जी एसआरए हार्डलबर्ग सीमेंट से, अश्विनी अरोड़ा जी, आशीष भरतराम जी एसआरएफ लिमिटेड से तथा प्रतिभा सिंटेक्स से चौधरी जी तथा मंचा सिंह, मध्य प्रदेश में इन्वेस्ट करने वाले कई प्रमुख उद्योगपति जो आज यहाँ पर मंचासीन है तथा यहाँ सभागार में उपस्थित समस्त महाकौशल क्षेत्र के प्रमुख उद्यमी बंधुओं, यह रीजनल इंडस्ट्री कॉन्क्लेव एक ऐसी शुरुआत है जो मध्य प्रदेश को एक अलग दर्जा पूरे देश में दिलवाएगा. यह शुरुआत उज्जैन से हुई. हमारे संचालक ने कहा था कि महाकाल से जो बात प्रारंभ हुई अब यह महाकौशल में पहुंची है. वाकई इसका कौशल विकास होगा और इस क्षेत्र के विकास के लिए यह एक मील का पत्थर साबित होगा. अभी आप लोगों ने महाकौशल क्षेत्र में पूरे प्रदेश के भी इन्वेस्टमेंट के अवसरों को समझा, मध्य प्रदेश सरकार की नीतियों को भी समझा, सभी प्रेजेंटेशन विभागों के दिए गए और असीमित संभावनाओं का भंडार आप लोगों के बीच में बताया गया है। अब इसमें आगे कैसे बढ़ना, यह सबसे महत्वपूर्ण कार्य। और यह जो कॉन्क्लेव है, यह कॉन्क्लेव की अवधारणा हमारे मुख्यमंत्री जी ने तत्काल शासन के बागडोर लेते ही उज्जैन से प्रारंभ करी, और इसका प्रमुख उद्देश्य है कि प्रदेश के सभी क्षेत्र सामूहिक रूप से विकसित हों। क्षेत्र विशेष में औद्योगिकरण होता है, यह एक परंपरा है, परंतु हमारे पूरे प्रदेश के अंदर जो प्रचुर संभावनाएं अभी आपने देखी है, चाहे पर्यटन की हो, खनिज की हो, उद्योगों की हो, कृषि की हो, इन सारे के अंदर किस तरीके से हमारे उद्यमी आगे आए। रीजनल इंडस्ट्री कॉन्क्लेव करने का जो सीधा प्रभाव होता है, वह प्रभाव